Hello everyone, I am Dr. G. Bharati from Physics Department of Kamraj College of Engineering and Technology. So in this presentation, I am going to discuss about vertical axis wind turbine. So this is the outline of my presentation. What is the need of renewable energy resources and types of wind turbines, vertical axis wind turbine and its advantages and disadvantages. So what is the need of renewable energy sources? So here we are day by day, the pollution level and water in the sea levels have been increased worldwide, and the depletion of fossil fuels can also occur. So we need a alternate energy source for fossil fuels. So one of the alternative energy sources, renewable energy resources. So one of the renewable energy resources, wind energy. So wind formation and all those things are discussed in my previous video. So in this video, I am going to discuss about the vertical axis wind turbine. So what is the use of this wind turbine? The wind turbine is used to convert the kinetic energy of the wind into electrical energy efficiently. So there are different types of wind turbines. They are horizontal axis wind turbine and next one is vertical axis wind turbine. In my last video, previous video, I discussed about the horizontal axis wind turbine. In this lecture, I am going to discuss about the vertical axis wind turbine. So horizontal axis wind turbines are the most successful types of wind turbines, and it is used worldwide for energy generation, and it is well researched. Its theoretical basis and everything is well researched. But the next type is vertical axis wind turbine. In this thing, the blade location is different. Somewhat it is a rotor axis is perpendicular to the wind, and the main components are all located at the base of the turbine. This is one of the difference between this and the horizontal axis wind turbine, but this one is yet to be developed. So vertical axis wind turbines are the emerging type of turbines. It is used for commercial purpose worldwide at some parts of the world, not in every places. So it yet to be developed. So this vertical axis wind turbines can be classified into two types. First one is Savonius wind turbine and second one is Darius wind turbines. So this Savonius wind turbines, they are having two half cylindrical blades. They are in S type. So it is called S type rotor. So here one is concave surface and other one is convex surface. This concave surface having the track coefficient is more for concave surface when compared to the convex surface. So the difference between the track coefficient between the two sides of these blades, it rotates the rotor. That is the track force. This difference in the track force, it spins the rotor. Finally, it develops a mechanical power. So this is one of the type of the wind turbine. It is called Savonius wind turbine. The second type is Darius wind turbine. So it is like an egg beater shaped one, and it's having high efficiency, but it's one of its disadvantages, it is not consistent, and exterior power sources are needed to operate it. So you have to initiate it before its operation. So and one of the advantage of this types of rotor is it spins many times than the wind hitting speed. So it is one of the advantages. So these are the two different types of vertical axis wind turbines. So these are all the different parts of the wind turbine. So it is on a lower hub, upper hub, and in the center part there is a soft guy wires, rotor blades, and the whole nozzle is at the base. Here there is a generator and a gearbox, and everything is at the base of this. So we will discuss one by one. So first one is a guide wire or guy wire. So it keeps the rotor soft. in a fixed position, and it maximizes the possible mechanical vibration. So it is the work of this guide wire. And next one is a hub. So it is a center of the rotor to which the rotor blades are attached. So this is the lower hub and this one is the upper hub in which the rotor blades are fixed. So it is made up of either cast iron or cast steel. It is it's having two hubs. So that is the lower hub and upper hub. It is a main portion of this vertical axis wind turbine. And next one, next part is rotor. So it is the heart of the wind turbine. So we are having multiple rotor blades. Here it is attached to the hub. So if the diameter of the rotor is increases and its efficiency is also increases. If it is greater, it is its efficiency is also greater. And these are the rotor blades. Either these rotor blades are having three different types. One is D type, H type, and helical type. So it is maximum. It is made up of either aluminium or a fiberglass or carbon fiber and all those things. So it converts the kinetic energy of the wind into efficiently into mechanical energy. Finally, this mechanical energy is converted into electrical energy by the use of generators. The next one is soft. So it is a part that this one is a soft impeller soft. This one is used to turn the turbine blades. So it is connected with the gearbox and generator within the main housing. It is at the base of it, the vertical axis wind turbine. And electrical breakings are available. So these electrical breakings are used to operate the vertical axis wind turbine in a safe mode. So it kept at a safe speed in faster winds. If it is too much heavier winds are blowing, then this electrical breakings are operated and the particular vertical axis wind turbine get stopped. And the next thing is mechanical braking. So this mechanical braking is, it is also called drum brake or disc brake. It is used to stop the vertical axis wind turbine when at emergency situations like wind wind gust and turbulence. Wind turbulence and all those things when happen, these mechanical breakings are operated. Next one is a gearbox. So this one is the main part of the vertical axis wind turbine. So it is it's having the low rotational, it converts the low rotational speed into high rotational speed and its output is sent to the generator. This mechanical energy is sent to the generator. So the part of the generator is, it is used to convert the mechanical energy into electrical energy efficiently. This is the working of the generator here. So next one is a base. So this is a base, is a the roof of the building that which is, it is to be installed. So the whole thing is on the top of the base only. Here it is a gearbox, generator, and everything is placed within the base of this vertical axis wind turbine. So this is the overall construction part of the vertical axis wind turbine. So it's having lower hub, upper hub, rotor blades, guide wire, and here there is a gearbox, generator. Initially, when the wind blowing, this rotor blades get operated, and they efficiently, this wind energy, this kind of kinetic energy is converted into mechanical energy. So through the soft, it is sent to the gearbox. In this gearbox, it the lower the rotations per minute is initially 15 to 20 rotations per minute. It will be converted into faster rotations. Then it's moving from low speed soft to high speed soft. The efficiency is increased. That is, mechanical energy is amplified in this gearbox, and finally it's sent to the generator. So in the part of the generator is, here this mechanical energy is converted into electrical energy and it's sent through the grid lines. So this is a basic working principle of vertical axis wind turbine. And there are some of the advantages and disadvantages of the vertical axis wind turbine. It is very effective in variable wind directions. It doesn't require any operational adjustments because it is in the base. Everything is in the base. So it does not require any operational adjustments. And it can function in any climate. and finally its maintenance is very easy. So these are all the advantages of vertical axis wind turbine, and there are some disadvantages also. So it's having lower efficiency rates when compared to the horizontal axis wind turbine, and it's having limited scalability. So it is not suitable for large scale wind farms, and it's somewhat expensive. So these are all the some of the disadvantages of vertical axis wind turbine. So we will meet in the next video. Thank you.